welcome to part 5 of my comprehensive Pokemon Platinum walkthrough. And we're pretty much picking up where we left off last time. So, Sandgem Town. Yes. And as soon as we get in, we run into Dawn. How nice. And she's going to force you to walk with her, because that's what happens in Pokemon. Oh, and she likes talking about stuff. That's good. Oh. That hurts. That was my face. My face. You stop walking into me. Seriously. Meh. Oh, well. Yeah, he does that a lot. He's got too much energy for his own good. And he's gone. Yes, Dawn, I would definitely echo that sentiment. What the hell was that? Yes, okay, we're going inside there now. No choice in that. Yay! Welcome to the Pokemon Lab. Pretty music. And now we've got to listen to him talk about his Pokemon, or my Pokemon, actually. Bumping about, saying hmm a lot. And, now. Nicknaming your Pokemon. You don't have to do this. I like to because it gives them a bit of individual character. Plus that means I can tell their name. The naming system is exactly the same as you used to. Now I've just got to think of a name. I know. I'm going to go something for something boring. Wrong button. Do-do-do-do. Well, no. We're going to call you Simia. Not Simia. Yes. There we go. So, Chimchar now has a name. Yay! So he's now going to talk about us and ask us to do stuff. This is a bit of a long talky session. And she's threatening you. And now he's going to introduce himself again because apparently we don't know who he is. Right. Yes, we've seen all this before. Thank you. Yes, the Pokedex. He's going to give you the Pokedex. This is the whole point of the game, apparently. Even when it actually has nothing to do with that. It's just something you can do. Fun thing, apparently. Apparently she's got one as well. So, yeah. Stop talking about stuff. I want to leave. She's got the Turtwig that we had on 201 available to us. Basically, even though she's actually got a different one, but we'll just say it's the same one because, oh well. She tells you who she is, what she does, and that she's not in fact a slave like I thought. She's actually doing that by choice. Wow, I'm amazed. Right. This is all story stuff. Right, just a second, I'll show you the Pokedex. This is a pretty cool little device. Record your encounters. If you encounter a Pokemon, it will become listed on here. Say, Piplup, for instance. Pretty much the only bit of information you get out of it is you've got all this information stuff on the bottom screen here. Use Chimchar. So yeah. When you catch a Pokemon, its description will come up. Apparently these little guys are very agile and extinguish the flame on their tail before they go to sleep to prevent fires. How nice. You'll also see its footprint, its height and weight, like we care, its type, which I'll go over in a sec, and then these options on the bottom screen here allow us to check where said Pokemon might be, and this is the date, this is the time indicator to tell. So, as you can say, area unknown, because you can't catch these things in the wild. There's only one in the game, and we've got it. Cry, which is just, if those physicists out there, will just give you a bit of a waveform and stuff. Not really very interesting. Much point of it, just playing around with stuff. Yeah, put the reverb on it. Anyway, that's pointless. And then a size comparison ratio. Allows you to check the height against yourself, because that's just what we do, and the weight against yourself. Okay. Yeah, on a one that you have only just encountered, you notice this Pokeball thingy on the here will be lit up for one that is caught, if you've caught it before, even if you don't have it on you. And if you have just encountered it, then you'll just see its name will appear there. and you don't get any information about it at all. Nothing about area. Really? Cry is the same, and you don't get a size base. So yes, that's the Pokedex, in a nutshell. Now, one of the things we do in Pokemon is try to catch all the Pokemon in the game. That is a very time-consuming process, especially considering there are 490-odd Pokemon in this game. So yeah. And you can do searches and stuff. It doesn't really matter. I'm not going to be using the Pokedex much at all. So, yeah. It's just a cool option. Right. There we go. Let's leave the lab. And we run back into Dawn, and he's behind me, but he doesn't walk into me, which is nice. He's got something good for me, has he? Well, better be. Better be good. TM27. This is an excellent time to talk about TMs. So, yeah, once he's busy talking about that stuff. Yes, 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 all that stuff. I'll talk about that in a moment with more zest than he does. I hope. She didn't know that he had TMs because she failed. She lacks my mentor and she'll force you to follow her around. So there. I'll talk about these in a bit. Yes, yes, all that stuff. Yes. These are iconic buildings, and you have to look for them in all towns. There are three primary buildings you have to look for in all towns, and I will tell you what those are in a sec. She's just going to tell us to do stuff, and then bugger off to the next route, because that's just her. Right. First thing you should do in Sandgem Town. You notice this little beach down here. This leads to a route that you get after you can use the move Surf, which we'll talk about later. You see this little Pokeball on the ground here. One wonders what that's doing there. That is an item that you can pick up. There are lots of these scattered around the world. Various different things. This one is an antidote. Antidote will cure poison. There are various other... I talked about the status afflictions already. Each one has a specific... potion sort of thing that will heal it. So antidote for poison, paralyze heal, self-evident, burn heal, again obvious, ice heal, again obvious, awakening will awaken a sleeping Pokemon, and a full heal will heal any status effect including confusion. That's good. There is one healing item, the full restore, that will do all that as well as healing your health. So that's good. Right, Sandgem Town. We should talk about these. Building with the red roof. This is your Pokemon Center. I'll just show you what the inside looks like. This is where you go to heal your Pokemon. This is the ultimate healing. This will heal hit points, power points, status, everything. Just give your Pokemon to the nurse, who we usually refer to as Nurse Joy. She'll put them on there, and you'll get a jingle, and there you go. Healing is done. Good. Pokemon centers in this game are unlike pretty much every other one in that there are occasionally battles that you will find in these Pokemon centers. So yeah, I'll try and show you all of those. This thing in the corner here is the PC. This allows you to access either your own PC for ball capsules and mailbox. Things I don't care about, though I can go over ball capsules once we get some. Rowan's PC, which will allow him to appraise your Pokedex for you. See, I've only seen three right now. And then someone's PC, you'll find out who that someone is later. This is the Pokemon storage system. Now you can deposit directly, or withdraw directly, or simply move around yourself. I prefer to do moving around because it's easier. Pokemon, and also the same with items. Now, we've got nothing in our boxes at the moment. These are the boxes, and you just list the Pokemon in all these boxes, and you've got all this space. 18 boxes. So, yes. A bit pointless at the moment, but, yeah. Any Pokemon you catch that exceeds your number of, your maximum number of Pokemon on your team, which is 6, will be automatically stored in the PC. So, yeah. Down here is the Wi-Fi stuff. I'll go over that when it's open. And up here is the, sort of the link stuff. I'm probably not going to go through this, to be honest. PC up here. Ah, this is where you go to sign the trainer card if you want to. But I'm not going to do that. Or am I? Yeah, I'll just... Yeah, there we go. Just did that for no reason at all. So yeah, that fills in that big white thing you saw on the trainer card. Wireless Club Union Room. This is where you can interact with many trainers, so things like... as I said, I'm probably not going to go through all this stuff. These are for battling with friends and stuff, and I've not actually really played with those sort of things, sort of wireless battles and stuff. But I'll do some stuff on that and eventually. Next thing to do, I will... Oh, the time's a bit late. Okay, in the next part then, we'll explore this and head on. So, hope to see you in the next part. Bye.